The fourth season of The Chosen continues to roll out on the big and small screens, and we've been sharing chats with cast members. This time, we're sitting down with the actors who play the roles of Jesus' two disciples. Paras Patel plays Matthew, and Noah James plays Andrew.
It's time.
What wondrous love is this, oh my soul.
Listen carefully to my words.
Soul.
To describe this fourth season, we're really now right in the middle. How would you describe what we're gonna see?
There's a lot happening, some sweet, some sour. Just go all in and eat it all.
It honestly is it's a tumultuous at times roller coaster.
What wondrous love is this, oh my soul.
We know this story, we know where we're headed, but there is hope. And there is a light at the end of the tunnel. And so that is most represented, I think, in this season.
The Son of Man must suffer many things. But you are the Son of God.
Are you play Matthew? What's the greatest lesson Para learns this season? What's the greatest lesson Matthew learns this season?
Well, in order for Paras to play Matthew, I just have to bring myself to the character. So I would say they're both intertwined. And one of the biggest things that Matthew learns this season is forgiveness, but also the value of continuing to just don't give up, just be the best person you can be, and don't let your past shame you.
Speaking of forgiveness, we see that forgiveness play out between your two characters. What was that like?
Yeah, that was really fun to embody, because to me, once Jesus calls Matthew, you know, we see a lot of disciples shocked, but we do see Andrew, and it was on the page there, have a little bit of, there was a little acceptance even in that moment of saying, well, if Jesus calls you onto the squad, like, what am I not going to buy in? But it's very difficult because in Andrew's eyes, Matthew is one of the main reasons that I almost lost my livelihood, almost would become homeless. So it's a hard journey, but I think there's always a want to accept Matthew.
It's very different from his brother, Simon, who has quite a different reaction. So that was a great moment to film, to see how forgiveness looks like, because it's not always clean. It can be sloppy. And so you see Simon Peter perceive it in one way and Matthew perceive it in another way, and to see it, them kind of come together at the end and find that has been great to see. And I've always told Noah that with his character, out of all the disciples, I felt like he was the only one that was willing to give him a bridge, like to see him properly. And it goes to what you were saying about how if Jesus says like this is someone right. to kind of value, then look at it in a different mm-hmm. light.
And it's really hard to take that message sometimes. And I feel like we all know that in our lives. If someone you feel like has wronged you, you know, can you really forgive to the point where you accept someone as a human being? It's really difficult. I know for me, Noah, that's a very difficult thing to do. So it's really lovely to see that play out on the screen.
That's why I think it's great the audience can watch this and kind of take what they you can learn from it.
Absolutely. I love the humanity of it all. It's like, these people are real people.
I don't expect you to understand.
I am the life that overcomes death.
I guess you're not holding back anymore.
I can't.
Describe for me, from both of your perspectives, what's the relationship between your character and Jesus like now? Because you've been chosen, you're with him. What's changed? What's it like?
Yeah, I'll say just quickly that, when in season three, I go down to the, Herod's dungeon and see John the Baptist there. And he says to me, you have a new rabbi now, follow him. You're focused on the wrong thing right now. And I think we really see the growth in Andrew and the growing pains in trying to take that message to heart. Because part of his heart is down there in the dungeons, and he wants to help, but he can't. And he's been told, focus on Jesus.
And as Jesus's scribe, Matthew is very devoted to him, but you'll see this season is just that personal relationship. There's a moment in one of the episodes, episode two, that comes out in theaters, that Matthew just thanks Jesus for listening. And I think the audience will love that, because that's who Jesus was to many people, and that kind of bond and relationship is very strong and can mean a lot. And I think that can apply to all of us.
I dread what is to come. Storing it in.
Episodes of The Chosen are in theaters right now. Episodes 7 and 8 will make their run in theaters beginning February 29th.